Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to a new series of Kun Fudhooliyan, where we will get your answers from Instagram and our asatizahs will answer for you the questions. So be sure to go to our Instagram link in our bio if you have any questions, okay? So for today, we have our Head of Education of Al-Mawaddah Mosque, Ustazah Aishah.
Assalamualaikum everyone, my name is Aishah. I'm a Head of Education at Alive Al-Mawaddah Mosque. Thank you for having me. I will be addressing some few questions that has been questioned by our youth at IG. Is it correct?
Yeah, I see.
Yes.
Okay, so the topic for today will be Fardu Ain. And without further ado, we will jump into the question. So the first question asked by the youth is calling to prayer a Fardu Ain?
Okay, thank you, Syakirah. Okay, that's a very interesting question. Okay, first of all, call or prayer. Maybe I can explain a little bit what the call of prayer is. Okay, if some of you did not know, call of prayer, or we also call as adhan, okay, is an Arabic word. And the root word of this adhan is from adina. Okay, adina means to hear, to listen, and to be informed of. Okay, so the purpose of adhan, as everyone know, that the purpose of adhan is to remind Muslim to come for mandatory prayer. And it has an adhan. We can hear our adhan or listen to our adhan how many times a day?
Five
times, very good. Okay, so it's for our mandatory five prayers. I mean, subuh, zuhur, asar, maghrib, and isha. Okay, so call for prayer actually made by our muadzin. Okay, the one who call for prayer, we call muadzin. The muadzin will call for prayer at our prescribed time of the day. Okay, back to the question. Is calling for prayer a fardu ain? Okay, I explained already about adhan. Okay, let me explain about fardu ain. Okay, fardu ain, we have fardu ain and fardu kifayah. Okay, fardu ain is an obligation for each of Muslim. Okay, it's an obligation prescribed for each and individual Muslim. Okay, that must be performed by oneself. I cannot do for you, you cannot do for me, okay, cannot. Okay, so example would be solat,
zakat,
hajj, saum,
and shahadah.
And shahadah. Very good, Syakirah. Okay, that's called fardu ain. We cannot do or perform for other people. Okay, what is fardu kifayah? Fardu kifayah is a collective obligation for all ummah. Mean if one person already did or done the obligation, the rest no need to do. Okay, so what happened is fardu kifayah is collective obligation for all, right? So if none of us did, all of us will be in a sinful. Okay, this the example of fardu kifayah. Example as building a hospital, solat jenazah. Okay, why? What is fardu kifayah? It's not fardu ain. Okay, example in the community, one quarter of you already know how to perform perform jenazah. So at least one person perform, the rest
follow.
Yeah, just follow. I mean, only yes. Okay. So and this fardu kifayah itself, do you know that fardu kifayah can be a fardu ain?
Okay,
so example in the community, only one person who capable to do and execute that obligation. So he or she will be considered as fardu ain. Be considered for fardu ain for him or her, because only he or she can able or capable to do to execute that obligation. Okay.
Faham. Okay. To sum up the question asked by the youth, is azan a fardu ain? The answer is no, it is a fardu kifayah. And fardu kifayah can be part of fardu ain if it applies to that one person in a specific group or country who is only capable of doing so.
Yes, right. Correct. If in the community only one person is capable to call for prayer, so he need to do it. is fardu ain for him.
Okay,
understand. Okay, so for in Singapore, we know that a lot of us actually already know how to call for prayer. So it's fardu kifayah for us.
Okay. Alright, syukran Ustazah. So moving on to the next question. What if our pimple pop before or during solat? Does it count as najis and is our solat valid?
That's a very interesting question. I never thought of that question. Okay, popping of pimples. Okay, popping of pimples considered as it include bleeding and also
pus.
Okay, so pus is considered as blood also. As all of you know that blood is considered as najis. Mm-hmm. So the question is, the matter is during or before the solat. Is it correct?
Yes.
Okay. So if it happened before the solat, you acknowledge that your pimple is popping. Okay. What you need to do is you need to clean first. You need to retake your wudu, then perform the solat. Okay. If during the solat itself your pimple is popping, but you do not acknowledge that, you just need to continue your solat. Same as if you have some injuries, mm-hmm. you do not know that it bleed during your solat, okay, you can just continue your solat. But if you know, okay, you acknowledge before the solat itself, what you need to do is you need to clean it. So as everyone know, hygiene is the most important topic, in Islam, because we need to prepare ourselves first, okay, mm-hmm. We need to be clean first before to take our wudu and perform our solat or perform or any obligations or any ibadah first. Okay, so in our daily life also, we need to be you need to practice hygiene. That's more important. Okay.
Alright, syukran Ustazah for that answer. So to sum up the question, if before you notice the pimple before, you have to bersihkan, right?
Yes.
So, but then if tengah-tengah solat you tak perasan or anything, so you just continue your solat.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
Thank you, Syakira.
That is all for today. Thank you for tuning in to Kun Fudhooliyan. Do submit any other questions if you have in our Instagram link in our bio. So we will do look forward to our following episodes. And that is all for today. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.